In this video, we're going to work on setting up unit testing with an add-on from the asset library called GUT. It stands for Godot Unit Testing, and it's a great asset to have, and you always want to have unit testing in your projects to make sure that everything is working as intended. So let's get right into it. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to make two folders for setup. One which is called test, which is an important addition for GUT. You have to have this test folder. You can name it something else and configure it differently, but the standard is going to be test. I'm going to create another folder. I'm just going to call this unit testing just to keep our unit testing stuff isolated in one folder. Then most importantly, we need to install GUT from the asset library. So if we go up to the asset library and just look for GUT, this is the one that you're going to want. So click into it, download it, install it, and we should be good to go. We need to reload the project though, and then after we do, you're going to see down in the bottom right next to shader editor, there's going to be a GUT text that we can click into. So let's reload the project. Okay, so that's reloaded, and now we can click into GUT, and this is where all of our tests, where we're passing, failing, and information around those tests are all going to live. So let's create some tests. We are going to be using, I'm going to create a new script inside of our unit testing and just call it hero. So let's open that up. I am going to actually just copy and paste a quick bit of code in here just to speed this up a little bit. And so I have a quick hero class for us right now, just similar to our player where we just only have health and we're going to take damage, heal damage, and check to see if our player is alive. Now that we have this set up, we can actually go into our test folder and we are going to create another script and call it test underscore hero. The test underscore is an important part of GUT as well. If you're familiar with PyTest, it's really similar to that. You need to have the test underscore and then you can call the file whatever you'd like. So let's create that and let's open it up. We need to extend from GUT test. That's going to enable us to actually use the add-on for GUT, and after that we need to preload our hero. So let's preload, search for hero, make sure you're not getting the testing script, you're getting our actual hero script. And then we're going to need another variable for hero, which is underscore hero, and it's going to be of our type hero. And before and after each test we need to do some setup. So we need to create a new hero before each test, and then we need to remove it from each test. So we're not carrying over any attributes from test to test that we don't want to. In order to do this, we can use two functions, which are going to be before each, and then we're going to have after each. In before each, this is where we're going to create our player, as I said. So we're going to assign our hero. Sorry, I keep saying player, but I mean hero. And we're going to create a new one. We're going to add a child to our scene for that hero. And then we're just going to do an await just to make sure that all of our setup is properly, is ready. So we're going to a get tree on the process frame. In after each, all we're doing is just going to queue free our hero. So we just remove our hero from each test afterwards. And the first test that we'll do is just going to test the initial health of our hero. And to do this, it's going to be one line, and we're just going to assert that two values are going to be equal, the hero's health and the hero's max health. And then we can add a message. So if it does fail, it will show us this message as what the intended test is supposed to be doing. So we'll do not player, sorry. Hero should start with full. Okay, now we can actually run these tests. I have a couple of configs set up that you can obviously tweak this to your liking, but I like to have exit on finish. Otherwise, it creates a temporary scene where you can view the tests, but all the same text from that is going to be in this box right here. I also changed the font a little bit here. And then you are also probably not going to have this out of the gate, but you need to make sure that you're grabbing the test directory, which for me is test, and select it. You can have subdirectories here, which you will want to select as well. If you have a unit test section, an integration test section, you'll want to select each of those directories that include tests separately. And just one bit, actually, as before we test this, just like we did for the file name with test underscore hero, every test also needs to be prefixed with a test underscore or else it will not get picked up by gut. So now that we have that, we can run all of our tests. And now we can see here, let me bring this up. Sorry, this is not showing a lot on the window. But either way, you can still see that this test was successful. Okay. I do have another, I like having text wrap here, especially since this is so small. It's a little jumbled, but you can still get the point. So now I'm going to copy and paste a few other tests in here just so you can see what gut looks like when there are more than one test. And I'm also going to include some tests that fail. So we have a heal test, a test damage where the subtraction is wrong. And then we're also going to test the healing overflow where if we heal too much, that's incorrect because our player has a max health of 100. This should not happen. It should never go above 100. So now we run all of these, same process. And now it tells us exactly which tests failed and some information around that. Again, if you're from a Python background and you're used to using PyTest, this looks pretty similar. And you can click in around here and it will take you exactly to the line where the test is failing. So you can see that this is failing on asserting that these two things should be equal, which they are not. It is, if this 80 was a 70, where we're taking 30 damage off of the 100 player health, then this test would succeed. So if we make that change, save, and run it, we should only have one test that's erroring out, which is the healing overflow. And that's it. It's a pretty quick setup, but it's very important to have for all of your games. You want to make sure that all of your methods and other game functionalities are functioning appropriately.